Welcome to Doctor's Advice. I'm Dr. Srinivas Kandula, Consultant Endocrinologist from Care Hospital, Mushirabad. Today, I'll be talking about osteoporosis. Well, many would have heard about the term osteoporosis. In osteoporosis, there is a decrease in bone density and bone quality, especially in the elderly population, thereby increasing the risk of fractures in this population. Women, especially in the postmenopausal group, are at higher risk of osteoporosis. This is because estrogen, an important hormone which is essential for bone health, is secreted in lesser amounts in a postmenopausal woman, thereby causing osteoporosis, whereby increasing the risk of fracture. Now, why it is important to treat osteoporosis? Why it is important to prevent fractures in osteoporotic patients? Whenever there is osteoporosis, the bone quality dramatically decreases, thereby whenever there is a trivial trauma, it could cause fracture at susceptible sites, like hip, fracture femur, spine and forearm. So whenever there is a fracture, this would lead on to this immobilization and immobility, thereby compromising quality of life. So it becomes very crucial to prevent falls in this susceptible group of patients and make sure the bone quality is maintained, thereby preventing fracture. Now, what are the age groups which are at risk of osteoporosis? Like I said, osteoporosis is primarily a condition seen in the elderly, and women are more susceptible to osteoporotic fractures than men compared to men because of estrogen deficiency in the elderly woman. In addition, osteoporosis can also be seen in younger population who have other medical conditions, thereby increasing the risk of fractures. Those conditions which increase the risk of osteoporosis in younger population are hyperthyroidism or thyroid hormone excess state, those patients having Cushing's syndrome or cortisol hormone excess state, those patients taking glucocorticoids or steroids from outside for various conditions, those patients who are severely malnourished because of gastrointestinal problems, patients with rheumatoid arthritis, patients who have inflammatory bowel conditions like Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. Along with this, elderly lean subjects with a history of smoking or alcohol intake, or those with a family history of fracture or a past history of fracture, are even more at risk for osteoporotic fracture. Like I have discussed, the common sites of osteoporotic fractures are femur, that is the thigh bone, forearm, that is the distal end of radius bone, spine, it could involve either the spine in the thorax or spine in the lumbar region, and also the hip. So next question is how to diagnose osteoporosis and how to treat osteoporosis. Well, diagnosing osteoporosis primarily by history, where if there is a history of fracture with a trivial trauma in the past, it would itself it is sufficient for diagnosis of osteoporosis in elderly population. However, we also have other imaging modalities like DEXA scan, where bone mineral density of various bones is calculated by a pre-programmed software, and depending on these reports, one can diagnose osteoporosis. The DEXA scan usually reports are usually in either normal or osteopenia or osteoporosis, where osteoporosis is the more severe variety, osteopenia is somewhere in the middle category, and normal means a normal bone density. However, it is important to note that elderly patients who had a fracture will have bone mineral density in the osteopenic range. Therefore, one should not deny treatment in this susceptible population depending on the results of the DEXA scan alone. Therefore, there is another tool which is a software primarily utilized by the endocrinologists and the orthopedicians called the FractScore, whereby considering the patient's age, body weight and other risk factors like smoking, alcohol and other chronic conditions like rheumatoid arthritis or diabetes, whether or not there is a history of fracture in the past, one would calculate a FractScore, and depending on the FractScore, one could choose therapy for osteoporosis in the subjects, even if the bone mineral density is normal or in the osteopenic range. Next, I'll move on to how to treat osteoporosis or osteoporotic fractures. Well, the whole purpose of treating osteoporosis is to prevent fractures. If there has already been a fracture, then it needs to be addressed by a concerned orthopedician in fixing the fracture. However, like I said, the whole purpose or the main purpose of treating osteoporosis is to prevent fractures. Now, how to prevent fractures or how to treat osteoporosis? Well, while following simple methods like preventing falls, muscle strengthening exercises, taking care of vision, gait, and also making sure that the surfaces at the office or at home are not slippery, one could prevent falls. In addition to this, one also makes sure that the calcium and vitamin D intake on a daily basis is adequate for normal bone health. Therefore, it is very important that those susceptible population, especially the elderly who are at risk of osteoporosis, are supplemented with calcium and vitamin D on a daily basis. And in addition to this, there is more specific therapy for osteoporosis in the form of either oral medication or injectable therapies, where that depending on the subject characteristics is and the cost and various other factors is chosen and given to treat osteoporosis. So that's it, friends. So I have given a brief introduction of what osteoporosis is, why it is important to treat osteoporosis, and how to diagnose and how to treat osteoporosis. Thank you.
We'll be covering all topics which commonly affect patients on a day-to-day basis.
For more this type of doctor advices or opinion or any other things,
దయచేసి డాక్టర్స్ అడ్వైస్ ఛానల్
లైక్ చేయండి, కామెంట్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి,
సబ్స్క్రైబ్
టు దిస్ ఛానల్ డాక్టర్స్ అడ్వైస్.
10 మందికి ఉపయోగపడేలాగా చూడండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.